वेलकम श्रीनिवास, इज दिस ऑडिबल? रिप्लाई इन चैट।
यस सर, यस सर।
या we are just waiting for two more minutes, then we will start today's section. We are just waiting for two more minutes. We are just waiting for two more minutes, then we will start the section. We are just waiting for two more minutes, then we will start the today's section. Today we are going to see a repeated part, which is actuator. So we are just taking a revision on this topic of actuator. After 2 minutes, then I will share the screen. After 2 minutes, we will start the section. Share screen. Okay, so here we are. I'm sharing the screen. So here we are to see the actuators. I again told you that we already studied this concept, but today I am going to repeat it because this is important. And from the next lecture, we are trying to take the numericals. So just an overlook on this concept of actuator here. So what is actuator? Actuator are those components of fluid power system which produces mechanical work output. Means whenever we are going to use hydraulic system, we need to convert the energy of oil or energy of hydraulics. So to here the actuator it is the device which is used to convert the hydraulic energy of oil into mechanical work output. You can see on your screen. They develop force and displacement which is required to perform any specific task. The task may be of any kind, to move, to press, to lift or to climb. So application of this actuator, you can say that application will be to move, to press or to lift. Then actuators are common for both hydraulic and pneumatic system. You know, just wait a minute. You know, in actuate hydraulic system, we are going to use the oil, and in pneumatic system, we are going to use the air or compressed gas. So, whenever gas is used, then actuator becomes pneumatic actuator, and when we are going to use the hydraulic oil, then actuator becomes hydraulic actuator. Actuator, it is the common component which we are going to use in both hydraulic as well as pneumatic system. The difference, you can say that in pneumatic system we are using the compressor, and in hydraulic system we are going to use the pump. Okay, the hydraulic actuators are made stronger to withstand with high pressure of oil and develop huge amount of force. When we require huge amount of force means more 2 bars. When we require to produce pressure or force more than 2 bars, at that time we are going to use the hydraulic actuator. And for small load or for small pressure which is below 5 bar, at that time we are going to use the pneumatic actuators. The other terms related to the actuators. So first term is speed. While selecting actuator, which qualities should be checked? So these are listed here. Speed of actuator, it should be taken in account while selecting the actuator. Flow control, flow rate or force developed by the cylinder, it also should take into the account while selecting the actuator. Force of actuator is controlled by controlling the pressure of working fluid using pressure control valve. How we are going to use pressure control valve, flow control valve? We already see it in this chapter. Then direction of motion of actuator is controlled by controlling the direction of flow of fluid by using direction control valve. I already shows you 3x4, 3x2 direction control valve, 4x2 direction control valve. How we are going to use this control valve to get the desired motion of actuator? We already see it in previous lectures. Okay. So here we are going to see the types of actuator. So there are 2 types of actuator mainly. First one is linear actuator, and second one is rotary actuator. Here you can see this video here.
The purpose of a fluid system is to transmit.
What I told you theoretically, that actuator is used to convert the hydraulic pressure of oil into mechanical output. So this is just shown here in animation format. Just listen it.
The purpose of a fluid system is to transmit power from one location to another. Fluid power is converted to mechanical power by means of an act. Actuator. Cylinder actuators deliver a linear push-pull motion.
Here what is happening, you are just using the pressure of oil, and from this pressure of oil we are getting the piston moves inward and outward. So what is happening here? We are converting the pressure of oil into the mechanical output here.
A rod and piston within a cylindrical tube. A single acting cylinder is a cylinder in which the working fluid acts.
It is single acting, single ended cylinder means there is only one connecting rod is connected to the piston, and single acting means there is only a single port through which high pressure oil comes and goes out from the actuator. That's why it is called as single acting. And why single ended? Because only one connecting rod is connected here.
On only one side of the piston. The other side of the cylinder utilizes a mechanical load, springs, compressed air, other cylinders, or the momentum of a flywheel to push the piston back in the other direction. This particular cylinder utilizes a spring on the non-fluid side. A single acting cylinder produces.
Here we are using the spring to bring the piston back to its original space. when the pressure of liquid from this side is removed. So what is happening here? Only pressurized oil remains only on one side of this piston. That's why it is called as single acting. And when both side of the piston remains oil, then we will call it as double acting cylinder.
Uses linear motion in one direction. When a control valve directs fluid through the inlet port into the blind end, pressure builds up and generates a force on the piston. When the pressure buildup is large enough, the piston begins to move, extending the rod. This is called the forward stroke. When a control valve directs fluid out of the port, the fluid pressure is removed. The force of the spring pushes against the piston in the other direction, and the rod returns to the cylinder. The purpose of pumps and hydraulic double acting cylinder is a cylinder in directions.
So this is the working for single
acting
cylinder.
A double acting cylinder is a cylinder in which fluid acts on both sides.
Now this is double acting cylinder. There is another second port is present to the other side of this piston. So that oil is present on both sides of the piston. That's why we are calling it as double acting single ended cylinder, because there is only one connecting rod is connected and oil is present on both sides of the piston. That's why it is called as double acting single ended cylinder.
Sides of the piston. This type of cylinder can produce linear motion in two directions. A double acting cylinder has two fluid ports, one on the blind end and one on the rod end. A directional control valve sends fluid through the blind end port while venting fluid out the rod end port back to the tank. Pressure builds up and generates a force on the piston, causing the extension stroke. When the directional control valve is shifted, it sends fluid into the rod end port, out of the blind end port, and back to the tank. Pressure builds up and generates a force on the other side of the piston, causing the retraction stroke.
So these are the working stroke, extension and retraction. We are going to achieve both the stroke of extraction and retraction by
a fluid system
using
is
the
to
pressure
into
of
the
oil.
Rod end causing action. We must first.
We are achieving both this stroke by the pressure of oil, and in single acting cylinder we are achieving the retraction stroke by spring action.
To determine the speed of a piston during extension and retraction, we must.
This is the internal structure of our actuator.
First, determine the significant working areas. The full piston area is the side of the piston without the rod. This is the area that feels pressure as the piston extends. The next significant working area is called the net area. This area is the size of the full piston area minus the area of the rod. The net area feels pressure when the cylinder or the incoming fluid takes up space. The cylinder will always retract fast. Cylinders work simple. Flow rate is the same and the piston areas are the same. The speed for extension, although their motion is linear.
So here we are to see the types of actuator. So there are two types of actuator. First one is linear and another one is rotary. Here on your screen you can see the types of linear actuators again. So linear actuators again having three types. First one is rotary cylinder, then second one is non-rotary cylinder, and third one is the special type cylinder. The rotating cylinder don't go on this. On the name of this rotating, it is linear actuator, means its cylinder is only rotating, but it produces the linear motion. Linear motion produced by actuator, then it is called as linear actuator. And if it is producing rotary motion, then we name it as rotary actuator. Here rotating cylinder means here cylinder is only rotating, but it produce the motion which is linear motion. That's why we are calling is that rotating cylinder linear actuator. The second type is non-rotating cylinder. It is having again two types, single acting cylinder and double acting cylinder. If only a single port is present for the entry and exit of oil, and this oil is present only on one side of the piston, then we name it as single acting cylinder. And when there are two separate ports are present for entry and exit of oil, and oil is present on both side of the piston, then we are naming it as double acting cylinder. I already shows you this single acting and double acting cylinder in previous video. Then we are having this special type cylinders. First one is diaphragm, then tandem cylinder, double rod end cylinder, telescopic, then cylinder with cushioning. I will show you this special type of cylinder one by one after this in next slide. Just see the video. So here you can see the cylinder is rotating, but its produce motion linear. That's why we are naming it as rotating cylinder linear actuator. And how, what is the rotating actuator? I will show you on next slide. Only concept is that just see this rotating cylinder, and through this rotating cylinder this piston is traveled in the linear way. That's why we are naming it as rotating cylinder linear actuator. These rotating cylinders are used to operate work holding devices such as chucks, where the cylinders are rotating and the piston is extended or retracted using the direction control valve. Here you can see from this red port, high pressure oil is coming inside, so that extraction is occurs, and this oil is removed through this port so that retraction is achieved here. Okay, the rotating cylinder are used in chucks, collets, mandrels, etc. to hold and release the workpiece while the spindle is running. Okay, its operation is easy, where no need to stop the machine, no need to chuck keys. The function of loading and unloading the job is very quick, and it saves the machining time.
Pneumatic piston O-shaped shutoff bore valve, ZSHQ 16K.
So here we are going to see here this rotary actuators. It is again having two types: limited rotating actuator, which is vane type, and piston type. Another one is continuous rotating actuator, which are based on direction and based on construction. I will show you these actuators one by one. Just see this video, in which you will get that how we are going to control, what is the need of rotary actuators.
Pneumatic piston O-shaped shutoff bore valve, ZSHQ 16K. There is a pneumatic piston O-shaped shut-off bow valve applies dual-piece bow valve construction. The valve body consists of two parts, primary and secondary. The bore core uses full through diameter, characteristic of large rate flow coefficient and limit flow resistance. The bore core surface is hardened under special process, so the surface is smooth and bearing proof. The seating material is carbon fiber enhanced Teflon, featuring fine cutting performance, excellent seating properties, and long service life. The actuator choose high performance dual piston pinion and rack mechanism, extending high driving efficiency and compact design. The nominal pressure rating of this series is PN 1.6, 4.0, 6.4 ampere. The valve's orifice range is DM millimeters, 15 to 300, and the applicable medium temperature is 60 centigrade below zero to 2500 centigrade. The valve is widely used in such industrial sectors, including petroleum, chemical industry, pharmaceuticals, light textile, paper making, etc. For cutting or switching medium in gas and liquid conduit, meeting diverse requirements and work conditions. The bone valve has following characteristics. 1. Valve-seat limiter structure, stable torque, reasonably pre-tightened and pistoned valve seat seating ring, maximizing operational torque. 2. Stem design against the fly-out, highly reliable and secure, bottom-mounted stem, which will not fly out because of excessive medium pressure, with no possibility of security thoroughly. 3. Unique fireproof design. Seating performance even under burning. The valve is a combo type made of stainless steel and surrounded by Teflon seating faces. There is a gap designed between the stainless steel seating faces and bore body. When Teflon seating rings are burnt by fire, the stainless steel seat presses down to the bore upon spring force, producing seating between the bore and the stainless steel seating faces. 4. Anti-static apparatus leading out step.
Here you can see to control the flow, means to make on and off the flow, we need to produce this rotary motion. So to get this rotary motion, we are using here rotary actuator. You can see here this ball is get rotated using this actuator here, which is named as rotary actuator. Okay.
Simplified and easy installed anti-static apparatus connecting the ball, stem, and valve body as a whole always. The static produced by operation of seating faces upon switching.
The components such as stem, then connector rod, then these are some extra assembly components which we are used for the for connecting the actuator with the ball along with the bracket here. So we are not having that concept, we are not going to make the assembly here, but how we are going to use actuator practically, you can see here in this video.
Will be let out. 5. Pneumatic switching will be let out.
So the complete assembly of ball along with the actuator here. The presence of this handwheel says that it can be manually operated also. When there is a power failure, at that time this actuator can be operated manually, else we can control this actuator using hydraulic oil or compressed air, whatever we have at the location. Okay, now we are going to see the another type of rotary actuator. So here we are. This is rack and pinion type rotary actuator. How this rack and pinion can be used to obtain this rotary motion, it's explained in the animation here. Okay. Here you can see this rack and pinion are used to obtain the rotary motion of actuator. This rotary motion can be used to open and close the ball valve. So we are having another video here. Here again, using this hydraulic oil, we are getting this rotary motion. That's why we are naming it as rotary actuator. This is non-restricted type rotary actuator. And this one is restricted type rotary actuator. This is restricted type rotary actuator and this is non-restricted type rotary actuator. So here again the theory which we see in this in previous slides that linear actuator produces linear or reciprocating motion. They can stay piston inside the cylinder. I already showed you the assembly of this actuator. When hydraulic oil is supplied to one end of cylinder, oil will exert pressure on piston and reciprocating motion of piston occurs. And in the various different types of this linear actuators are rotating cylinder actuator, non-rotating cylinder, linear actuator, then special type of linear actuator. So here we are going to see this again in 2D format here that how that rotating cylinder is used, then how that works. I already showed you that how that rotating cylinder linear actuator works in animation format already. Okay, so here this is the single acting single piston rod cylinder. I already showed you this in animation format also. This is the compressing spring which is used for retraction stroke of this cylinder. This type of cylinder having application in sequencing circuit or in tamping the workpiece. The symbol is similar to the construction. Single acted spring return actuator cylinder can be shown by this symbol here. Just wait a minute. So this is single acting spring loaded cylinder. How it works, I already showed you in animation. This is extraction stroke when high pressure oil comes on the one side of the piston. This is double acting cylinder and this is the symbol for double acting cylinder. This is cylinder, this is piston, this is connecting rod. And we are showing the two vents through which the oil comes and goes from the cylinder. That's why we are naming it as double acting cylinder with single piston rod, or simply we can call this as double acting cylinder. So double acting cylinder can be drawn like this also. So the special type cylinder, which is diaphragm cylinder, when we require very small linear motion, at that time we are going to use the diaphragm cylinder. This diaphragm cylinder used for very small displacement. Diaphragm is used instead of piston. It deflects due to hydraulic fluid. When hydraulic fluid comes from this side, then this diaphragm goes in downward direction or towards right direction. This piston moves out. And when we remove the force of hydraulic oil, then diaphragm comes to its original position and this connecting rod. Piston rod moves inside. So you can normally assume here that very small displacement is obtained, and when we require very small displacement, at the time we are going to use the special type cylinder, which is diaphragm cylinder, diaphragm type cylinder actuators. Okay. So this is double rod end cylinder. When we are going to connecting rod on both side of this piston, then it becomes double rod end cylinder and working is same. This is special type cylinder or tandem cylinder. In tandem cylinder, there are multiple partitions present inside the cylinder. That's why we are naming it as tandem cylinder. Else working is same. Only difference is that there is multiple partitions are present. You can see here, this is the partition in the cylinder. That's why we are naming it as tandem cylinder actuator. Again, this is the important concept. This is the telescopic cylinder. In telescopic cylinder, more than two cylinders are mounted, one inside another, and when we required extraction force or when we applied high pressure hydraulic oil, then these cylinders comes out one by one. This type of cylinder, telescopic cylinder, we are going to use in mostly cranes and dumper lifting. You see in dumper lifting here, one by one the cylinders are coming out, and for this kind of cylinder we are using telescopic cylinder, where the cylinders comes out one by one, producing a high or more linear displacement. Telescopic displacement can be shown by this diagram also. Then cylinder with cushioning. You know that when these cushioning are provided for the safety purpose of the cylinder, so that cylinder will cushioning. We are producing this cushioning to the cylinder just for the safety purpose, so or to increase the life of the cylinder. So it is if the cylinder is long, it is its stroke length is more, the speed is high, then naturally the piston impact on the end cover is considerably high. Continuous hammering of piston on this cover plates causes loosening of tie rods and leakage of the fluid. Also, it will damage the cover plate. Hence, to avoid sudden impact of piston on the cover plates, cylinder with cushioning are used. Construction is same, only we are providing the cushioning here, nothing other than this. Cushioning is provided just for safety purpose or to increase the lifespan of the cylinder. When there is a long linear displacement is present, then the speed of piston moves in and out increases, and this piston can impact force on the walls of the cylinder. To avoid this, we are producing the cushioning at the bottom of the cylinder. Okay. And this is the concept of cylinder mounting. Foot mounting, then pivot mounting. We will see this concept in next lecture. Today we are stopping here. If anyone having doubt, then you can call me or WhatsApp me on my personal WhatsApp number. I am going to share the link of link for today's attendance on your WhatsApp group. This link will be will remain active for next 10 minutes only. We are stopping here. Thank you.